afternoon and happy Friday. Well, the Aussie market just extended its winning streak to a sixth straight session. We ended the day at around our best level, up by 106 points or 1.3%, which means we just had our best day of the month. Now, that means over the course of the week, we gained 2.5% to have our best week of the year. Now, this week's gains have mostly been driven by strong sessions over on Wall Street following heaps of data this week, like business inflation, consumer inflation, and just last night we had retail sales, which have all eased fears about a US recession and has also supported the case for a US rate cut in September. So markets have been quite optimistic, of course, after quite a rough week last week, and things are certainly looking better. We are creeping back up towards that 8,000 point mark at 7,971 points. Now, looking across the different sectors, we can see that all 11 improved today, many of which improved by over 1%. We saw the materials sector, which really needed a nice strong gain because it's been doing quite poorly on the back of a fall in iron ore prices. So that sector was up 2% today. The energy sector, similar gain there, up by 2.2%. Industrials up 1%. Financials, the biggest sector on our market, up by 1.6%. And tech stocks gaining 1.2%. So pretty broad-based gains right across the market. Now, in terms of the individual winners, Zip, buy now, pay later company, performed best after announcing its partnership with US financial services company Stripe, which facilitates online payments. NAB improved after its third quarter results came in broadly in line with expectations, and that's despite flagging a higher rate of late mortgage repayments. And shares of A2 Milk soared after resolving their dispute with their partner Synlait, which was ongoing since late last year. Now, looking at some of the losers though, plastic packaging company Amcor was at the top of the losers list after its full year sales dropped by 7%. So Amcor ended the day with a decline of 2.8%. Domain reported a lift in revenue and profits over the year, while expenses also dropped. A healthy property market, particularly in Sydney and in Melbourne, helped to drive its results. Now, this is the exact same thing that we heard from their bigger rival, REA Group, just last week. That company is, of course, behind realestate.com.au. But today, Domain's results did fall a little short of expectations, so we did see its shares fall at the end of the day, even though they were up by a sizable amount earlier in the session. Now, looking over to currencies, the Aussie dollar has maintained some of its strength. It is currently buying 66.3 US cents. We are stronger against most of the other currencies except for the Kiwi, which is down by about a quarter of 1%. Now, looking ahead to next week, it is going to be a little bit quieter on the economic data front, but there's still going to be plenty to keep us busy. Of course, it's going to be week 4 of Aussie reporting season, which means things are really going to start to heat up from here. So we'll have plenty more companies, dozens and dozens, out with their latest profit results. That'll certainly keep us busy. We have the latest meeting minutes from the interest rate meetings just a couple of weeks ago from the RBA and also the US Fed Reserve. And we have the Jackson Hole Symposium, which is a 3-day annual meeting of central bankers, academics, policymakers, and the like when they sit down and discuss very important things. But we'll get into the details next week. I hope you all have a lovely weekend.